So glad you could drop by.
Hey, doll. Case has got a lot murkier.
You mean Wilson?
Yeah, which is up at Laurel Canyon. He's under the car.
I just got back myself. My source in the LAPD called a couple hours ago. So I went down to the scene, dressed as a cop reporter. That's how I got the Merc Bay steering wheel. And I had the watch back, too. I got the blood type off it, and it was a match to some residual blood that I had found on Lady Claremont's dress. Do you know, those fools over at the LAPD didn't even notice that the blood on her dress wasn't her own? Sloppy, sloppy.
Nichols.
Charlie, it's Mona. I went to see Tony.
Mona, what are you doing? Trying to get yourself killed?
Oh, Charlie, you're right. I don't know what I was thinking. I went to see Tony to apologize. These men grabbed me and they tied me up. Well, then they took me upstairs, but I was able to break loose.
Where are you, Mona?
I'm outside. I'm in the phone booth in the alley behind Tony's, opposite Dinah's Junction.
All right, stay there. I'm on my way.
Well, Charlie, it sounds like someone's coming. Oh, he sounds awful. He sounds like he might be holding a loaded gun.
Mona, get out of there!
What do you want? What are you doing? What's that in your hand?
Mona!
Oh, it looks deadly!
Mona!
Oh, don't! Please, don't!
Mona! Mona!
I'm gonna drive over to the alley behind Tony's. I know I was listening to the NBC rebroadcast of the Leaders and Earls. Boogie Woogie Dance All Important and Coffee Clutch. But I was thinking of Mona and what some big ape was doing to her. Got me so upset I almost drove the LaSalle into a traffic light trying to get the images out of my head. Yeah, I knew the alleyway she was talking about, but I didn't want to go. Much darker than most Hollywood alleys. Sure, it has street lights, but they don't seem to shine anything. They just seem to make silhouettes out of the fedoras and trench coats and cigarettes of the two-bit toughs, trying to find anonymity in the dark. The stale air of the alleyway. Sometimes you can catch a faint breeze from the city beyond the borders, conga lines and movie premieres, starlets and golf caddies, palm trees, big-shot movie executives with phones by the pool. But then in a flash, it's gone. Back in that alleyway behind Tony's on Sunset and Kahanga. And the only sound you hear is the drip, drip, dripping off the gutter on the liquor store. And the air you breathe is the Hollywood's heavier, more common, lying low to the ground, slowly, steadily rising like a fog over the fitted sinks and rearing hopes. Like a million different raindrops on a million different tidal roofs up in the Hollywood Hills. Draining into a million different alleyways just like this one. Dotting the city like stars. It's easily the world's most pressing alley.
Yeah?
So you figure them Dodgers could take the panic?
How should I know?
Now I know. I just figured since you ran numbers, you had an inside scoop.
You was mistaken.
Hey, Henry.
What?
You know that donut shop down on Melrose and Fairfax?
Stands.
Yeah, Stan's. I was down there on Tuesday. Get this. They added a new donut with sprinkles on it. It's new. And it's got sprinkles.
So it's got sprinkles.
That gives them six. Six different kinds of donuts. One more handy. One was all they need.
For what?
Huh?
For what? The donuts. All they need for what?
Oh, for seven. That'll give them seven different donuts, Henry. That means you can go there every day, all week long, and you'll have a different donut every day. Only
and you talk to the boss. He's been at Catalina all day.
He sent a wire.
A wire?
I don't remember. You're coming this way.
Well, well, things are looking up, ain't they, Louie? It's Charlie Nichols, arriving just in time like he was Santa Claus himself.
Oh, geez, Charlie. You know you shouldn't come back here.
Give me a girl and I'll be on my way.
Well, we ain't got no girl, Charlie.
Nah.
We got you, though, so the evening hasn't been a total loss.
Where's Mona Livingston?
Mona Livingston?
Mona ain't here, Charlie.
No, we ain't seen that broad in days. Not since you got on Tony's bad side for asking that kid without his permission.
Let's go.
Ah, that just about enough can push around the likes of you.
Yeah? Well, we're gonna keep pushing. So you might want to come to terms with your situation. Get him, Louie.
I hate to do this, Charlie. Oh. I'm awful sorry, Baptist. I just feel awful.
Oh. Hold it.
What are you doing, Louie? He's still
please.
Standing for crying out loud. Mix it up, you pansy.
He asks nice, Henry.
Louie, look out!
I got shot. Jeepers, that's marks.
Yeah? Well, you deserved it. What is this? Kid's bandana?
No.
Are you here anywhere else?
I don't think so.
How's that? Snug?
Better, I guess. I'm kind of tingly.
Good. This one you need firm again.
I deserve that.
Yeah, you did. So, where's Mona?
She got away, Charlie.
From a couple of big guys like yourself? Nah, I don't think so.
She's very resourceful. You know that.
Thurmond case is over, so why the hit job?
I know what you're talking about.
Talk! You understand? Okay. Here.
Okay. I got another boss.
Bugsy?
Nah, not Bugsy. Not for this. I can't. I just can't.
What can't you do, Louie? What can't you do?
I got the jitter, Charlie. I never wanted to hurt no one too bad, you know, but I was told to do one bad thing and then another. And I just can't.
That's it. Come here. Tell me what's going on here, Louie. Tell me.
I can't. I'll get killed.
Are you getting
that impossible.
You're getting killed either way, Louie, so you might as well come clean, son.
The butler. Charlie, I know the paper said he done himself in, but I can tell you, it wasn't no suicide.
Yeah?
That was my car, Charlie. I did it. I didn't do those other murders. I swear I didn't. And I didn't want to do this one either, but I had...
No. Who are you working for, Louie? Who are you working for, Louie? Who?
Charlie!
Oh, Mona! Oh, you're all right?
Oh, I'm good. I heard the shot. Were you hurt?
Yeah, I'm okay. I got out of there all right.
Oh, Louie! Is he dead?
No. Just sleeping. Him and Henry.
Oh. Did Louie do it, Charlie? Was he the killer this whole time?
Nah, he's just a button man.
Button man? What do you mean?
It's his job to take the dirty laundry to the cleaners.
I don't understand.
You know, he's a trigger man, a Bruno, a Chapito, a Trapper, a hatchet man.
You mean he hurts people for money?
Crystal clear, baby. Now it's our job to find out who he's working for.
Oh, all this killing, it's so awful. Oh, protect me, Charlie, please.
Protect you, baby. It's all right. But first, we better make sure that pistol of yours is all right. What do you say we continue this conversation back at my place?
Let's am scrape.